I actually have some experience in that field because in 2011 we won elections in Berlin on the basis of a liquid democratic platform. Like, we essentially, it allowed us to bring together our best ideas and remix them long enough until they were smarter than any of us individually. So we found a way not only to aggregate our intelligence, but to even produce an improved version of it. And that was totally amazing. And this effect of collective intelligence actually made us win elections, because it was so overwhelming good ideas that we brought out to the people. And in every conversation on the streets, we were just so much ahead with the thinking that we would just surprise all the electorate, and they would just go, wow, that's amazing. And a lot of other things went wrong after that, but the first step was amazing, and I see that as a potential. As we have a huge governance problem with the two models of democracy that we know are both dysfunctional in different ways. Like, the direct democracy is dysfunctional because it ends up being populist quite frequently. It doesn't really go any fact-based or science evidence-based way. And the other one, representative democracy, may be less bad, but it's terribly susceptible to corruption and to all kinds of special interest influence. And it's bringing our planet to a halt. I mean, we are having huge problems with everyone just thinking about their own interests, and then the environment of the entire planet just doesn't count anymore politically. It doesn't have a voice, and it doesn't end up going anywhere. So this liquid democratic approach, which is in between these two extremes, has even by now, it has even been analyzed scientifically. In 2015, there has been a scientific paper on it. They made an analysis and found out that it's less bad than the two extremes. And if we applied that to a large constituency and let them participate in the creation making of policy, not only we get a better collective intelligence than the European Parliament or many other parliaments, Congress, etc., we also get a high likelihood of policy being corruption free. And that's, whoa, very useful.